magandang hapon Malacañang Press Corps. I-welcome muna natin mga bisita ni spokesperson from Toyota Tsusho Philippines Corporation. Welcome po. Let's now have Presidential Spokesperson Harry Roque.
Good afternoon, Philippines, and good afternoon to the ladies and gentlemen of the Malacañang Press Corps. At 6:45 this morning, I got a text from the Executive Secretary asking me to inform the nation that the President was visibly upset with the missing 23,015 sacks of apprehended smuggled rice in Zamboanga City. The Executive Secretary asked me to tell the nation that the President has ordered an immediate and thorough investigation of this incident, and that instructions were given for both the NFA, OIC, and the Customs Commissioner to immediately place on preventive suspension individuals who may be part of the scheme. No? As of 10 o'clock, I got a text from Commissioner La Peña, and he summarized what he has done as follows. No? Nagpadala ang pamunuan ng BOC ng isang team of investigators sa Zamboanga para mag-imbestiga. Pinatawan ng administrative relief si Zamboanga District Collector Laiceo Martinez at Custom Police District Commander Felimeno Salazar. Sa ngayon, patuloy ang ginagawang pagbawi ng nawawalang bigas sa Port of Zamboanga na nagresulta ng mga sumusunod. Una, noong October 1, ang pag-recover ng 5,000 sako ng bigas sa Basulta Traders Corporation Warehouse. At pangalawa, noong October 2, ang pagbawi ng 3,000 sako ng bigas sa Sutterville Warehouse, Manga Drive, at 8,000 sako ng bigas sa Kasanyangan Compound, Santa Catalina. Ang mga imitaryo ng mga na-recover na bigas ay patuloy na isinasagawa sa mga nasabing lugar. Patuloy pa rin ang imbestigasyon alinsunod sa kautusan ng ating Pangulo. Magandang balita po sa mga magsasaka sa Davao. Nasa 3,720 na po na magsasaka at kanilang pamilya ang inaasahang matutulungan ng pagtatapos ng konstruksyon ng Mal River Irrigation System sa Davao del Sur na pinasinayan ng National Irrigation Authority. Ang proyektong ito ay pinondohan sa ilalim ng Japan International Cooperation Assistance at ito ang kauna-unahang proyekto na tapos ng National Irrigation Sector Rehabilitation and Improvement Project or NISRIP. Ito ay magbibigay ng sapat na tubig sa 2,635 hectares na agrikulturang lupa sa mga bayan ng Matanao, Kiblawan at Hagonoy. We're now on top of the ASEAN Manufacturing Purchasing Managers Index in September. According to the Nikkei ASEAN Manufacturing Purchasing Managers Index, the country got a score of 52. There are 7 countries measured, which included the Philippines, followed by Malaysia, Vietnam, Indonesia, Thailand, Singapore, and Myanmar. Questions from the Malacañang Press Corps?
MPC question. Celerina.
Good afternoon, sir. Sir, follow-up lang regarding sa nakawanchan sa Zamboanga City. I think this is not the first time na those confiscated by the Bureau of Customs were stolen or lost. Kasi there was an instance in the past that parang worth around 3 million na dried seahorse were also stolen or lost in that area. Any stringent measures or penalty to be given against this erring official?
Siyempre po, may kaparusahang kriminal yan, pero sa ngayon po, sabi nga po ni Commissioner La Peña, suspendido na po ang Zamboanga District Collector Laiceo Martinez at Custom Police District Commander Felimeno Salazar.
If ever sa customs lang ba, walang other agencies that could be involved?
Well, inutusan din po ng ating presidente at ng ating executive secretary ang officer in charge ng NFA dahil ito po ata ay nawala sa mga warehouse din ng NFA. No? So wala pa pong report sa akin ng officer in charge ng NFA kung anong nagawa niya. So anyway, malinaw naman po na meron ng kinikilalang OIC. So this finally resolves the issue of whether or not Jason Aquino is still administrator. He no longer is because there is now an officer in charge.
Okay, may follow-up. Joseph Morong.
Sir, slowly this time. The names again ng preventive suspension?
Okay, alinsunod po sa...
The names na lang.
Oh, kautusan ng presidente na imbestigahan at isuspende ang lahat ng opisyal na may kinalaman sa nawalang mga bigas na nahuli na smuggled. Sabi po ni Customs Commissioner La Peña, sinuspende na po sa serbisyo ang Zamboanga District Collector Lycio Martinez at ang Custom Police District Commander na si Felimino Salazar.
Sir, yung involvement ng dalawa, may nasabi ba niya how they were involved in the missing rice?
Wala pa po, no? Administrative relief lang po ito. Ito ay for the purpose of ensuring na they cannot tamper with evidence and that they cannot influence the investigation.
Sir, again, it's really obvious, but what does this establish? Talagang may nagpapalusot. Kaya ba mahal yung bigas? Ganun ba yan?
Well, ang ibig sabihin po nito talaga ay unang-una, may nag-i-smuggle. Number two, na ipapasok nila ito at nabibigay sa pribadong merkado. No? Pangatlo rin, may mga warehouse talaga na nagtatago ng mga bigas, no, na hindi naman nailalabas sa merkado.
Sir, you mentioned several amounts. October 1, ano yun? And then October 2, may 3,000. Well, ang unit nito, sir, sacks, no?
Hindi sacks.
Okay. So, noong October 1, sir, ano yung sabi mo na may nakita?
Well, October 1, na-recover po ang 5,000 sako ng bigas sa Basuta Traders Corporation Warehouse. October 2, nabawi ang 3,000 sako ng bigas sa Sutterville Warehouse, Manga Drive, at 8,000 sako ng bigas sa Kasanyangan Compound, Santa Catalina. So, ang total po niyan ay 16,000 sacks. Pero ang nawala po ay 23,015 sacks.
Mm-hmm. So, sir, yung...
Hindi. So, ibig sabihin, mga more or less kalahati pang hinahanap natin.
Do you think this is a wide practice? I mean, probably not just in Zamboanga.
Well, nagalit po talaga presidente because how do you lose 23,000
exactly.
sacks, no? I mean, it's incredible, no? Obviously, it cannot be done in a clandestine manner. Nakita ng lahat ng linalabas itong mga nahuling bigas at incredible. At kagalit-galit naman talaga na napupuslit ang ganitong karaming bigas na nahuli na ng gobyerno na being smuggled.
Follow up?
Sir, sorry. Yung mga warehouses, wala bang liability?
Well, I'm sure po, pinag-aaralan na po ang kanilang liability pero hindi pa po natin alam kung ano yung investigasyon dyan.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
May follow-up? Follow-up, Hannah?
Sir, posible pa bang madagdagan yung dalawang natanggal? Kasi I'm not sigurado, hindi lang silang dalawang involved doon, kundi yung iba pang nasa mababang posisyon. Does it mean na may, sa susunod na araw may matatanggal pa, madadagdagan pa?
Well, ang pag-uutos po ng presidente was directed to the NFA OIC and to Customs Commissioner La Peña. Wala pa po tayong report na nakukuha sa NFA kung meron na siyang ginawang hakbang.
Kasi ano assurance natin, sir, na natanggal yung dalawa? Pag nag-die down yung issue, baka bumalik yung practice if kung ito nga yung practice doon, sir. Kasi hindi maraming involved, hindi ng dalawa para ma-smuggle yung mga bigas, sir.
Tama po yan, pero I think naramdaman nila ang galit ng presidente, no? At tingin ko ay alam na nila na gagamitin na ng Estado ang lahat ng kanyang kapangyarihan para masupil na itong ganitong mga patakaran.
Okay. Follow up, Ina?
Sir, you used the term scheme to describe what happened there. Can you, if you have any initial information on how this scheme supposedly works?
Wala po. This is all that I got from Commissioner La Peña.
But is it maybe safe to assume that both Customs and NFA officials are colluding to make this happen?
Investigation is ongoing, but I think it's obvious that because both agencies had some jurisdiction over the apprehended smuggled rice, na parehong opisyales ng Customs and NFA probably have liability for this.
Okay. Other issue, Pia.
Hey, sir. Sir, I'm sure you have been asked about this yesterday. So how do you explain the president's absence during the PAG course event yesterday in Malacañang?
I was looking at his schedule. He had a schedule almost every day. He did not really have a day off. So the president decided to have private time. No, I myself would have wanted to see him. I was expecting to see him in the PAG court check turnover, but he decided he wanted to take the day off. But I'd like to assure you that the 5 billion check was not absconded by Executive Secretary Medial Dea. It was turned over to the President, and the President was very happy with the 5 billion peso check.
Sir, there were rumors yesterday that President Duterte was hospitalized in the morning. How true are these rumors?
Well, absolutely no truth to it. He just took the day off. And you can check the schedule. You have a copy of his schedule, right? The problem with the president is even on weekends, he visits military camps. I can't cope up, so I don't go with him anymore. I rely on transcripts whenever he has speeches in these military visits. No? But as far as I'm concerned, I reserve Sunday to myself, which the president did not reserve for the past 2 weeks, I believe.
Sir, how is the president's health, and how did he respond to these reports?
I don't think he really cares about the rumors. We're about to see him again this afternoon. There's the command conference, and there's a dinner with the PMA Alumni Association.
Yung health niya, sir, kumusta?
The health is fine. The president is a lawyer. He will inform and conform with the Constitution if there is a serious health ailment, but there is none.
Thank you, sir.
May follow up? Bernadette.
Sir, did the cabinet meeting push through po yesterday po?
No, it was reset for the 8th.
Bakit, sir?
The president took day off, di ba?
Pero kailan po, sir, in-announce yung postponement po ng cabinet meeting?
It was announced the day before.
Tuesday.
The day before. Basta, if there was a cabinet meeting, it was the day before. I know this because, well, in fact, today I have Secretary Anyo waiting for me. We were supposed to meet on the day of the cabinet meeting. So it was a sudden decision to move the cabinet meeting.
Sir, may we know the agenda po para sa cabinet meeting po?
Wala pa po akong kopya. Normally, binibigay lang nila on the day of the meeting itself.
Okay, sir. Thank you po.
May follow-up, Julie?
Sir, if President Duterte decided to suddenly take a day off yesterday, was he feeling very fatigued for him to necessitate a day of rest?
I don't think he was fatigued. He just probably realized he hasn't had a day off.
Tina?
Sir, good afternoon. I think, sir, kaya may issue kasi we are used to seeing the president very active during sa mga engagements niya and even sa close-in and open coverage. Even if you said he took a day off, did he not just go to maybe hospital? If he was not hospitalized, did he just undergo a regular checkup?
I assure you that I have no information that he did go to a hospital, and I'm given information whenever things like this happen.
So you have no information, but you have no personal knowledge that he did undergo a checkup?
That's accurate, but I have inquired, and I have my sources, and he was just in his residence.
In Malacanang, sir. Malaco.
Here.
Thank you, sir.
RJ?
Sir, update po on the foreign investment negative list.
I don't have it yet. They haven't issued it. I know you followed up, but all I can do is follow up also what happened to it. There's a couple of documents that I'm awaiting signature on, including the certification of urgency of the universal health care. So maybe I will also inquire. But one of the things I would do now when I see him is ask him to physically sign the urgency of the universal health care bill.
Okay, sir.
Maybe I will also inquire about the foreign investment negative list.
Thank you, sir. Sir, the PACC has listed the following agencies as the top agencies with most number of corruption complaints. Number one, DPWH, 2, GOCC, followed by DNR, DOF, DFA, DOTR, and NCIP. Sir, is the president aware of this, that DPWH has the most number of corruption complaints?
I do not know if he is aware, but that's the mandate of the Anti-Graft Commission. And I hope they will expedite their investigation so that they can file the corresponding complaints if warranted.
Okay, sir.
Bernadette.
Sir, can you confirm that Secretary Pernia went to the office of the President yesterday to further clarify final items on the FINL po and for possible signing by President Duterte po?
I did not see him, although there were lots of secretaries yesterday in the guest house. But Secretary Pernia was not one of those whom I saw. And I was in the guest house morning, midday, and afternoon. So I do not know, but maybe he did. But there were quite a number of people in the guest house yesterday.
But sir, kailan po kaya natin ma-expect na masasignan yung FINL po within the month?
Okay, I will call Secretary Pernia. I will find out what is the problem and if it's a matter of being signed. I may bring the list together with the certification of urgency of the universal healthcare personally for the President's signature.
Sir, damay ko lang. Yung sa World Bank po, sir, may we get the palace reaction po dun sa pag-lower po ng growth forecast ng World Bank po sa country from 6.7 to 6.5 po. And the bank also noted that high inflation can cause slowdown of poverty reduction po. So what's the palace take on this po?
We respect the lowering of forecast, and we note that the lowering is not really a major lowering. No? It's 0.2. So we expect the Philippine economy to still grow at a very robust growth rate of 6.5. That should still make us the second fastest growing economy in the world, if it does happen. Now, of course, we're all worried about inflation. No one is not worried about inflation for as long as you rely on products that you have to buy in the market. But as I said, we have taken measures to check inflation, including Administrative Order Number 13 and Memorandum Order Number 26, 27, and 28. This is without prejudice to the application of what is provided under the train law, which is the suspension of increased excise taxes if the price of crude oil breaches 80 for a period of 3 months. In addition to that, we are actively, of course, distributing the conditional cash transfers, the unconditional cash transfer under the train law, the Pantawid Pasada program, no, as measures to help alleviate the effects of high inflation rate.
Are we still on track, sir, on poverty reduction targets?
I believe so. That's why we're spending more now on alleviation measures.
Okay, sir, thank you po.
Joyce Balancio.
Sir, later ang event ni Pangulo ay joint command conference ng AFDP and PNO, so dinner with Philippine Military Academy alumni.
As I mentioned earlier.
May kinalaman po ba dito, sir, ang Red October ouster plot? Do we expect na pag-uusapan to doon?
Once a month po itong command conference, as you know, and I will give you updates too on what happens to that meeting. Whereas the Philippine Military alumni is, I think, it's also a regular thing once a year, no? So, wala naman po kinalaban ng Red October. Alam niyo po, again, we have no doubts Red October exists, but we also have no doubt that nothing will come out of it because of the incredible support of the people to the President.
Hindi naman po magsasagawa ng loyalty checks si Pangulo.
Hindi na po kinakailangan.
Okay, from Tina Maralit, sir. Reaction daw po dun sa sinabi ni Senator Kiko Pangilinan to stop dragging the LP sa Red October plot because the military already cleared them of any involvement.
Well, I don't think the military cleared them at all. I think the intelligence report remains. Investigation is ongoing, and if we obtain additional evidence, then perhaps it will be followed by the filing of cases. Let's allow our law enforcement agencies to do their work.
Okay, thank you. Rosalie?
Sir, sanction po ba ni Pangulong Duterte yung pagre-release ng info ng AFP regarding sa red tagging ng 18 universities and colleges?
That's intelligence report of the AFP. That's her job. Pero, and quite frankly, if you ask me, it hardly surprises me. Because of course, the CPP-NPA will try to recruit students. But the reality is, none of the schools, I think, will openly endorse such a recruitment. And of course, this recruitment is undertaking in a secret manner, no? So it's not as if they will have a booth for students to enlist to become members of KM or CPP-NPA. But let's face it, they are recruiting. It's not a cause of worry. It's just a statement of fact. But we have no doubts that none of the schools are openly supportive of such initiatives.
So, sir, ito po yung inline dun sa binanggit nyo po nung nakalipas na ang magagawa ng Duterte admin ay ihayag sa publiko yung mga efforts.
It's a statement of fact. At alam nyo, ambisyoso talaga yung CPP-NPA. At tagal-tagal nga nilang gustong buwagin ng gobyerno, wala naman nangyayari sa kanila. So, dream on.
Pero, sir, ang binabanggit po kasi ng mga student activists, mas open sila sa repression and abuses dahil po sa bibigay na ganito.
Dalawang taon na po ang presidente, wala naman pong pinapaarestong kahit sinong estudyante pa, no? So pabayaan nyo sila. Ang presidente nga po, napakataas ang tolerance sa freedom of expression. The one thing we have to give credit to the president, no? He's okay. Not bothered. Ang ayaw lang niya yung mga dayuhan ang mag-criticize sa kanya. Yun, nagagalit siya.
Okay, Rose Novenario.
Hi, sir. Good afternoon. Sir, yes, sir, alam ba ni Presidente yung pagsibak dun sa number 2 man ng PIDEA dahil sa di umano'y pagkakasangkot dun sa nawawalang 6.8 billion Shabu? At well, ano kaya kung, yung ano niya do reaction?
Well, hindi ko po alam kung alam niya, but let PIDEA officials do their job. No? Kung nagsibak sila, and there is of course a security of tenure to one's employment, they must have good grounds. No? So we trust that there are good reasons for the termination.
So hindi kaya ito contradiction dun sa sinabi ni Presidente na yung 6.8 billion po yung sa magnetic filter 2 eh, na parang sinabi niya ano lang yun eh, hindi totoo na may lamang shabu yung magnetic filter. Pero sa budget hearing ng PIDEA, inamin ni Director General Aaron Aquino na yun ngang mismo official nila sangkot eh.
Well, hayaan na po natin sila dahil sila nakakaalam ng mga katotohanan dito, no? I'm sure there was a process before they decided to terminate, and we stand by that decision.
So ano yung marching order po sa PIDEA na tungkol
gawin
din sa...
Gawin nila ang trabaho nila, no? Kung meron talaga nakipagsabwatan sa mga drug smugglers, sibakin sila lahat, no? At patawan ng parusa.
Kasuhan, sir?
Kasuhan, syempre. Hindi lang tanggalin.
Thank you.
Okay. Babalik muna tayo sa Red October. Henry.
Secretary, yung binanggit ng Pangulo na eliminate all rebels, ano po ito? Anong konteksto nito?
Konteksto is he wants to end the insurgency by next year.
Ano po ito? Shoot on the spot? Pag nakakita ng NPA ang pulis at sundalo, barilin agad? What is that?
They have to comply with the laws and customs of warfare. There are rules applicable to non-international armed conflict. And of course, every professional soldier or policeman will have to abide with IHL.
Ang NPA ang ikonokonect ang primary mover nitong Red October pagpapatalsik sa Pangulo. Hindi ba na pag-uusapan ng total war, all-out war, laban sa NPA?
Eh, alam nyo, meron naman talaga tayong putukan laban sa NPA. So, ang katotohanan, kay all-out, kay hindi, eh mahina naman talaga yung NPA. They have pocket territories. The ICRC classifies them as low-intensity conflict. So, hindi naman talaga sila napakalaking banta, as in fact, they only have pocket territories. No, that's important because yung applicability ng laws and customs of warfare will only apply in areas which are actually controlled by the NPA. No? So, kakaunti naman po ito. So, ang pagkakautos ni Presidente, kaunti lang naman yan, sige, tugisin na natin at tapusin na natin itong insurgency by next year. Pero syempre, the military option is only one. We still offer packages for rebel returnees and we're still addressing the root causes of rebellion, which is poverty, through our different poverty alleviation programs.
So bukas pa rin yung option na makipag-usap ang pamahalaan, hindi lang doon sa anggulo ng localized peace talks. What about yung sinusulong ng mga negosyador natin na usapang pangkapayapaan? Ito ba yung bukas pa?
Well, sinasabi natin na habang may buhay, anything is possible. No? Pero hanggang hindi nga pumapayag yung liderato ng CPPNDF sa complete ceasefire, sa pagtigil ng pangolekta ng revolutionary taxes at yung pag-uusap ay sa Pilipinas, hindi po matutuloy ang usaping kapayapaan.
Ulitin ko lang, kung may makitang NPA ang mga pulis at sundalo, anong utos ng Pangulo?
As usual po, no, that according to the laws and customs of warfare, force must be necessary and proportional. Kung hindi naman po magpapaputok ang NPA, dapat hulihin yan and charge them with rebellion. Pero kung magpapaputok pong NPA, then of course state agents have the right to use force.
Thank you.
Last two sa Red October, sa Larina and Julie.
Sir, regarding dun sa military, for the past weeks, parang apparently 70-80% of the president's schedule, yung mga meeting niya with the military, laging may military. Although you mentioned that there's no need for a loyalty check, don't you think that this is tantamount to a loyalty check?
Well, ang problema kasi kung titignan mo yung ibang schedule ni Presidente, from day one, ikot ang ikot siya sa kampo. So I wouldn't say na ito talaga ay loyalty check. Talagang from the very beginning, prioridad ng Presidente ang kapakanan ng mga sundalo. Yun na talaga ang pulisiya niya since day one in office.
But sir, it appears na since lumabas tong sinasabi na Austar plot, ay mas naging frequent yung pagdalaw niya sa mga military camps.
Well, siguro hindi yan loyalty check, no? But it's just the president sending the message na importante ang kanyang mga kasundaluhan at ito ay napapatunayan ang kanyang walang tigil na pagbisita sa kanila.
Okay, thank you. Julie?
Sir, back to the Metro Manila universities. The PNP and the AFP said that they're going to coordinate with the schools regarding the recruitment allegedly of NPAs. Won't this pose a danger of stifling legitimate dissent and academic freedom?
I don't think so. There was no order to curtail academic freedom. There's no order to curtail freedom of expression. Everyone should learn by way of example from the president who has not only practiced ultimate tolerance on freedom of expression, but has also practiced maximum tolerance on peaceful assemblies for redress of grievances.
But for example, sir, in the University of the Philippines where you yourself came from, the university does not allow the entry of PNP and AFP personnel. Won't you think that the presence of military personnel might, you know, send a chilling message to the activists that they are being watched or monitored?
As far as I'm concerned, the security forces continue to honor that agreement.
Okay, Deo De Guzman.
Sir, kayo na po sinasabi niyo, pockets of territories lang ang meron ng NPA. And then, basing from the line of your statements kanina, you're belittling the group. Bakit po umabot pa ng more than 50 years yung insurgency nila? Ay, pero alam nung kaya naman pala ng government.
Eh, kasi kapwa Pilipino, yan ang katotohanan dyan. Hanggat maaari, ayaw natin patayin ang kapwa Pilipino, no? At saka, come on. Sila na lang ata natin tirang Maoists in addition to the one in Nepal, no? The original Maoists have become billionaires. Dapat sila lahat mag-group tour sa People's Republic of China nang makita nila kung ano nang dapat nilang gawin at tumigil na silang encircling the cities, no? In order to bring down the establishment. Kalokohan na po yan, ako mga Maoists. Magising na kayo sa katotohanan. Naiwan na kayo ng panahon bago na po ang mundo.
Following that, sir, sabi niyo po next year ay matatapos na yung insurgency, matatapos na ang NPA. Ano pong bago na gagawin ng government?
Hindi naman goal naman yun, ikaw naman.
Ano pong bago na gagawin ng government? 50 years na po sila. Ano pong bago na gagawin ng government to stop that?
Ang bago po sa akin, yung package na binibigay natin sa rebel returnees. Bagamat sinasabi natin na kaya natin silang sugpuin dahil meron tayong malakas na hukbong sandatahan, eh meron pa rin compassion, no? Na kapag naman sila ay sumuko, tutulungan natin sila magkaroon ng bagong buhay.
Meron po bang ganong parang pag-asa na ipapakita talaga ang government doon sa mga members nila na talagang may maibibigay na pagbabago ang government sa kanila?
Well, ako po kasi nakamit na ako na isang Amazona na talagang nag-surrender, no? At nakakahabag damdamin yung kwento niya, no? Nung nasabi niya na napakatagal niyang nahiwalay sa kanyang anak at na-realize niya na talagang mali naman yung pinaglalaban ng CPP-NPA, no? Na talagang po pwede naman makamit yung mga gusto natin sa mga mapayapang mga pamamaraan. So hindi po ako pessimistic na mas marami pa tayong mga mandirigma galing sa NPA na mapapasuko kasama na po dyan o dahil na po sa mga pangako ng panibagong buhay galing sa gobyerno.
So yung persuasive power po ni Presidente malakas?
Tingin ko po, dahil lalo na po dun sa Davao where they're most active, no, dumadami rin po ang mga rebel returnees.
Okay, Christine Abendano. Christine.
Sir, just to clarify, you said parang may cabinet, maraming cabinet secretaries yesterday sa guest house. So, yun ba yung supposedly there was supposed to be a cabinet meeting yesterday?
Talaga naman po may scheduled na, kailan nga ba, hindi ko maalala kung kailan yung scheduled cabinet meeting na kahapon ata yan ba? Or what day after, I don't know, I don't remember anymore when it was. There was a schedule and then it was reset to the 8th, no? Pero kahapon, I did see, well, the usual naman. It's just
pero
that
why was
most of the time, you don't see a lot of them. But yesterday, madami naman sa guest house, no? So, but I only saw the usual. CABSEC, ES, Bongo.
Pero why was it reset? Because the president
Martin
decided
Andanar.
No,
there were just meetings ongoing.
No, I mean, you said na reset because the president decided to take a day off yesterday.
Well, marami rin. Like ako, I was supposed to have a meeting with Secretary Anyo and Secretary Tugade. Hindi na natuloy. And we just agreed na for Secretary Anyo today because there's going to be command conference.
No, I mean, sir,
and with Secretary Tugade for next time. Pero it's the same naman. It's the palace-based secretaries who were just meeting yesterday.
No, I mean, it was reset because the president decided to
take a day off yesterday. He did not want to push through with his schedules. No?
Pero have you seen the president or talked to him?
Well, as I promised Senator JV, that for the certification of urgency of the universal health care, that if need be, I will go to his residence and I will take a picture of him. But I don't think that will be necessary because there will be a command conference later and a dinner with the PMA.
Why would you say that you need to take a picture, sir?
Eh, parang matigil na yung talk, no? There's lahat kayo texting me about his health. Ano ba naman ang gusto niyo pa sabihin ko? Sinabi ko na sa inyo, siguro naman may track record ako na kapag seryoso yun, sasabihin ko. Pero hindi naman talaga, no? Maraming wishful thinking dyan. Makarma sana yung nagwi-wishful thinking na magkasakit ang presidente, no?
So mamaya may video, sir, or picture?
Hmm?
May video or picture? Because it's closed, eh.
Ay, di, ako na ang kukuha ng picture. Sige, o, ayan. O, sige, ako na magkukuha ng video. Magpapabati ako. Nagpapabati si Joseph Morong, sabihin ko. O, ayan.
Follow-up, Ina.
Sir, just to be clear about it, are you confirming that there was supposed to be a cabinet meeting yesterday? Because it's not,
hindi ko maalala
it's not in the schedule
kung kailan
yun.
When was it?
Kailan ba?
Wait. Hindi ko maalala kung kailan yun. May regular naman yung mga cabinet meetings, di ba?
Was it supposed to be yesterday?
Wait. Wala na. Na-update ko na yung calendar ko, kaya wala na siya. So, I can't remember when it was supposed to be.
So, are you, sir, was there supposed to be one yesterday or not?
I'm not sure if it was yesterday. I'm not sure if it was yesterday or Tuesday. I can't remember now, no? But
so,
there
sir,
was supposed to be, and it was reset for the 8th. Meron. Nabura ko na kasi, na-update
na
yung calendar
ko. And that is the reason why cabinet secretaries were in Malacanang yesterday.
It was complete. I don't think it was. Kasi it was the palace-based secretaries na, who were all there in the guest house yesterday.
On the president's day off, they were at the guest house.
Yeah, well, I can only surmise that part of what was being discussed is the budget hearing in the Senate, among others, the status of PCOO. That's why there was a meeting attended by Secretary Martin Andanar. But I said since... So, yun yun. So, yeah, that was one meeting that I surmised was going to be the subject matter.
Raymond?
Going back sa NPA. So, you've mentioned sa NPA na dream on sa kanilang ideology. And yet, it's proven as a matter of fact sa mga nakaraan na ang dami ng Pangulo na nag-dream on na sugpuin daw, tapusin in so and so na yung NPA. Pero until now, they are existing. So, dream on pa rin yung pagsugpo sa NPA. Anong meron sa Duterte administration na this time hindi na dream on at you can actually realize that dream?
Well, tingin ko yung combination ng puso para sa mga miyembro ng NPA na bumalik at saka yung political will na pag hindi kayo bumalik, eh talaga mauubos kayo at mapupulbo kayo.
Pero the elements of a revolution, for example, yung stomach revolution, yung inflation, eh nariyan pa rin yung mga elemento ng pakikibaka at pakipagtunggali. So,
hindi na pang press briefing yan, pang group discussion na yan, no? Pang DG na yan. So, let's schedule
ultimatum,
another one.
Ultimatum, last point. Any ultimatum or dream on ultimatum?
Ang sinasabi po natin is, hindi na po kayo magtatagumpay. So, sa mga mandirigma ng NPA, yung inyong inspirasyon na China, kapitalista na po, hindi na po sila nakikipaglaban, nakikipagnegosyo na po sila, nakikipagkalakala na sila. So, kung gusto ninyo, pumunta na lang kayo ng People's Republic of China at mag-ambisyon na rin kayo maging bilyonaryo gaya nung mga mga kapatid ninyong Maoist sa People's Republic of China.
Okay,
gumising na kayo sa katunayan na laos na yung paniniwala ninyo.
Okay, last four.
Laos na.
RJ, Apia, Joseph, and Nestor.
Sir, Commissioner Bellica too said that Congress remains to be the most corrupt branch of government.
Who?
Because
which?
They continue to use the pork barrel system. Does the palace agree?
Well, I don't. All I know is that there's a decision against the pork barrel system, and that if he says it persists, I hope he will file charges against individuals. That's their mandate.
You're from there, sir. What was your observation?
What do you mean? What was? Party lists, individuals, congressmen, unfortunately, the reality is we're second class in Congress. No, so I think you should ask the district congressmen who control the district engineers of the DPWH.
You don't agree, sir, that it's the most corrupt branch?
Wag namang most corrupt. There's corruption. Wag namang most corrupt.
That's from the PACC, sir.
Well, as an ex-congressman, that's unfair.
And according to him, Congress should also be abolished.
I disagree because it's part of our democratic system.
Thank you, sir.
Pia muna or Nestor? Pia.
Sir, there's a suggestion from the DILG to disqualify those in the narco list from running in the 2019 elections. Ito rin po ba ang gusto ni President Duterte?
Point well taken, but the President is a lawyer. He knows that they cannot be disqualified unless they have been convicted with finality, and the penalty or accessory penalty of disqualification from public office has been decreed by the court.
Thank you, sir.
Nestor.
Good morning, Secretary.
Medyo madami kayong tanong ngayon, ha?
Secretary Andanar mentioned...
Parang feel na feel nyo magtanong ngayon, ha? Oh. Oh.
Secretary Andanar, in an interview this morning, mentioned that there are at least 7 to 8 cabinet members who is eyeing to run for the 2019 elections. Is the President aware of this, and how is he preparing for the possibility of this, since this will affect government service, given that we have only 1 week before the official filing of candidacy?
The President will not run out of appointees. For every cabinet official that leaves, there's probably 100 people interested in one post. So there will not be a shortage of individuals to fill in the slots or the vacancies to be vacated by cabinet members who are seeking public office.
Na-inform na ba siya, sir, with these 7 to 8
Hindi ko po alam. Members? I know with one office, he knows from the very beginning.
Nestor?
Yes, Nestor. Okay na.
Okay, may tanong ka, Bernadette? No more na? Oh, last question. Oh, sige, last two na lang si Joseph and Maricel.
Sir, patanong ni Alexis Romero ng katabi ko.
Bakit nga ba nagpapatanong na tayong dalawa?
Doon sa tanong. Oh. Sir, nagpataya nga si Presidente sa loto.
I mean, sabi niya.
Ano sabi, sir?
Narinig ko rin yun sa balita. Hindi, sir. At kung narinig ko yun, sabi ko doon sa aking sarili mga kasama, ako diri, tayaan nyo. Oh. Ewan ko kung nagpataya na. Nagpataya ako, meron daw dito sa malapit sa barangay hall dito eh.
Oh, pero sir, sa akin yun eh. No? Ha? Ako yung mananalo doon.
Sir, di ba meron daw dito? Oh.
Sir, regarding the President's health, I mean, parang every month, may mga ganyan na kumakalat na rumors.
Marami kasing wishful thinking. Maya naman kayo, yung mga nagnanais na magkasakit yung presidente, no? Lalo kayong magnais na ganyan, lalo lumalakas.
Correct, sir.
Siguro i-reverse nila.
Sir, ano, is the...
Kasi kulit eh. Ang kulit eh. Pag-reverse nila yun.
Sir, are you serious about your...
No. It's just that nakakapagod na eh. Sasabihin nila, may sakit. O, lalabas na makas. Malakas pa sa kabayo. O, tapos, sasabihin nila, nawala. May sakit na naman. Ano pang sasabihin ko? Sabi nila dati, may dialysis. You know what I did? One time, ginanong ko yung kwelo niya. Anong ginagawa mo? Tinitignan ko kung meron ka dialysis. Ay, wala naman. O, tinignan ko yung ganyan niya. Wala rin. Ginanong ko talaga. O, wala. O,
pero sir, to rest the issue, no? I mean, is the palace willing to maybe issue a medical bulletin? Although the requirement in the constitution is only when there's grave illness. But since this is persistent, what do you think of issuing?
Well, ang punto lang is, please trust that if he has a serious ailment, the people will know. And of course, I keep on repeating this, he's a lawyer, he knows his constitutional obligation. If there's a ground to release it, he will. But for the time being, let's continue to treat medical records as being confidential.
Okay. Thank you.
Maricel?
Good afternoon. Sir,
Just a quick follow-up on Nestor's question. Does it mean, sir, that the president already made up his mind on who to appoint just in case na mag-resign na yung sinasabing 7 to 8 cabinet officials?
Hindi naman po siguro because I wouldn't know. But ang sinasabi ko lang is, wala naman pong problema yan. For every vacancy, there's 100 applicants. No? So, wala pong problema mga kapalit.
Pero sir, since next week na siya, how will it affect the operation of the executive department if it's indeed true na 7 to 8 officials yung mawawala?
Medyo wala pong epekto because there's always a rule. When there's no secretary, there's always an OIC appointed. So there will never be a vacuum in any cabinet position.
Okay. Okay, thank you, sir.
Okay, no more questions? Chris?
Thank you.
Okay, Chris?
Sir, grabe namang wait lang. 1 hour na tayo, no?
Okay, maraming. No more questions?
Ghost question? Anong ghost question?
Sir, so are you running ba? Are you running for senator?
I think we'll soon find out because the deadline is on the 17th. So we will find out from the 11th to the 17th.
Bakit sir, ayaw mo pang sabihin?
Hindi pwedeng sabihin yan dahil nagtatrabaho pa ako as spokesperson. See, it would not be proper.
But you can say yes naman, sir.
It would not be proper for a spokesperson to be talking about political plans.
Okay, thank you, Vance.
Yes.
Okay, maraming salamat. Malaking yung press call.
Thank you. See you on Monday.
Thank you, Presidential Spokesperson Harry Roque. Back to my studio sa Radyo Pilipinas and People's Television Network.